Hey y'all, what is up? Welcome back to my channel for another part of the Sims 2 to Sims 4 series. So we are in Strange Town still. I'm so sad. We're almost finished. Okay, after this week's video with the Grunt family here, we have two more. And I'm really sad about it. But anyways, guys, we're recreating the Grunt family of Strange Town in their house. So the Grunt family was my favorite household to play in Strange Town. I know I feel like I say that with every family I recreate. Oh, I love playing them. Just because I like playing them, okay, doesn't mean they're my favorite, but this family right here was my favorite, and I think it was because they reminded me so much of the Pleasant family in Pleasant View, just because they look very dysfunctional and their personalities clash and they didn't get along, and I really felt for the sons. So let's go ahead and talk about them. So as you can see, the Grunt family is a military family. It consists of General Buzz Grunt and his three sons, Tank, Rip, and Buck. So Tank, which is the one with the the face paint all over him. In The Sims 2, he has the same face paint, but it's not as extreme. But that is the only custom content that I could find that resembled, you know, how his character in The Sims 2 looks. So just, yeah, keep that in mind. He's not that extreme, but he does keep the little face mask. But anyways, he wants to be just like his father, while Rip Grunt wants some romance. So apparently he's like a little player wannabe, and he really is the complete opposite of his older brother. He really wants nothing to do with the military life, it seems like, and he kind of just does his own thing. Kind of seems like a very rebellious child. And then little Buck Grunt is just left out, and that's really sad. But anyways, General Buzz Grunt actually had a wife. Her name is Lila Grunt. Apparently she divorced him and was later electrocuted under mysterious circumstances. And she is buried in the Spectre family graveyard, which they are the last family we're going to be doing. So in 2 weeks, we will be doing the Spectre household, and that's an interesting video I'm excited to do, because there are theories that she is a serial killer. So you see that there? She was electrocuted under mysterious circumstances. So, But anyways, General Buzz and Tank, they both have a grudge against the Curious family for being so strange, and the Smith family due to them being aliens. But Rip and Buck have positive relationships with the Smith kids. But anyways, General Buzz Grunt, he is at the top of the military career, so he likes to, I guess you would say, like, rule his kid or raise his kids in a military type style. So he's very, very strict. And his house, obviously you'll see their house, looks like a domesticated boot camp. It's just like very clean, very in order, and I could never live in a house like this because, oh my god, if my parents depended on me to keep the house this clean, oh my god, they'd kick me out, because I am the messiest person and I'm just not into that life. But you know what? General Buzz Grunt, he's got it going on. He rules with a military hand. But anyways, their house number is 51, which is most likely a reference to the highly secretive military base Area 51. So his wife Lila obviously took the important part of emotionally caring for their children. You'll see that most of them gained all their skills. Like, she taught them how to walk, talk, be potty trained and everything. So I'm sure when she passed away, it was, you know, really hard on them. You know, I can't imagine losing a mother. I know maybe some of you have, and really my heart goes out to those who don't have either a mother or father figure in their life, because a mother and a father has important roles. And so, you know, as kids or toddlers or whatever growing up, their mom was there for them, emotionally there for them, and then when she passed away, I'm sure it was hard on their father, and it just probably kind of made him a little bit harder on them, which is really sad if you think about it. But Anyways, General Buzz Grunt, he has many feuds with a lot of people in Strange Town. Obviously, Olive Spectre, because, I mean, his wife died on her lot. The Curious Brothers and Loki Beaker, who he won fights with them all as teenagers. And his most recent feud is with Pollination Technician 9, apparently because he lost a fight with him. I don't know, I guess Pollination Technician 9 used his alien skills on him. but many people interpret Buzz as trying to get aliens to leave Strange Town. But anyways, it's crazy though that he is feuding with these people because he actually has a higher relationship with his enemies than his own sons. So that's like really sad, like I said. And then Tank, he's actually a teenager, but when I created him, I don't know why I made him on accident a young adult, which I mean, I guess it's fine. Anyways, he's a young adult and how I recreated him. I think I really thought he was a young adult, but apparently not. He's a teenager. And he wants to follow in his father's footsteps, and he aspires to become a general like him. They have a good relationship, but Tank wants to impress his father by getting into the military job. And he's also a part of the feud against the Smith family. He's enemies with Johnny Smith, which is the teenager alien in the town, and he wants to win a fight against him. But yeah, it says when he's first played, he is 5 days away from becoming an adult. So I feel like when I played him, the majority of his life was a young adult. So I think that's why I thought he was a young adult, but he was actually a teenager when you start. But anyways, what's sad is that he considers his father a friend, though the friendship is not mutual. So obviously that's like hack the game, you know. Sim team did that because, you know, usually once you're friends with one, the feeling is mutual. So anyways, that's just really sad that he considers his dad a friend and his dad's like, no. And that's, oh my god, that's like sad. That is damaging. I can't even imagine. And then Rip Grunt, he is the middle child. And he actually works part-time in the slacker career as a gas station attendant. So he does not have an interest in the military. Also, he is the only member of the household to have any, like, playful personality, like, points or whatever. The rest of them, I guess, are just kind of, like, serious. He absolutely does not get along with his father and his older brother, but he is friends with his younger brother. So I'm assuming that he's not friends with his father and Tank because, you know, of their military life and how he really wants nothing to do with it. And he is actually pretty decent friends with Ophelia and Johnny Smith, which are part of the feud with his father. And he is a romance sim, but he does not have any romances when the family is first played. Okay, and so the last little sim in our family is Little Buck Grunt. He is the youngest. He is very studious and smart, but he is very serious, but also he's a really sweet kid. He has an A+ in school. He is the nicest member of the Grunt household. He also has a good relationship with some of the Smith family members, despite the feud between his family. So overall, he gets along with his family, but is somewhat distant from his older brother and his dad. And according to his bio, his accomplishments are largely ignored by his father, which, oh my god, like my heart breaks. He is overweight when the family is first played and is 4 days away from becoming a teenager. He wants to be a pet stylist to the stars, although there is no such career or level in any job. So yeah. I think that's why I like that family so much, is because, you know, it's just, that's like a really fun storyline to play with, like a dysfunctional family. Like, you could go so many different ways with it. And yeah, their house was very easy to build, probably the easiest house I've built yet. And I'm proud of myself because I got a little bit creative in the back, as you'll see, because unfortunately The Sims 4 does not have the awesome careers that The Sims 2 and Sims 3 have. I don't understand. Like, at first, I took up for The Sims 4, you guys, because, you know, I know a lot of people are like, Sims 4 sucks. And, I mean, when The Sims 4 came out, I couldn't play The Sims 3 for the longest time. And, of course, I hadn't played The Sims 2 in forever. So I kind of just, like, forgot, really, how good those other games were. And, you know, I love The Sims 4 in the sense that the graphics look better. And I like the emotions behind it. I like the creative sim. There are aspects of The Sims 4 that I absolutely love. But, you know, since I've been playing The Sims 3 and The Sims 2, I'm seeing, yes, the graphics and stuff has improved. But there are just so many things that we lost, and I just don't understand why. Like, you would think that when games advance, you would just add to it and you would keep all the things that we love. So now I get what everybody is saying, where they're coming from when they complain about The Sims 4. But, you know, there was a military career. I don't understand why we don't have a military career. That was one of my favorite careers in The Sims 2. And they had, this is what I'm talking about when I got creative, in the backyard, they have a, like, a military training thing or whatever. And so I try to, like, copy it. I use, like, benches and stuff. So that's what that is back there. You're probably like, what the hell is that? That's what that is. I tried. I could have just left it blank, but I didn't. And also, there's also a swing set in The Sims 2 in their backyard for, I'm assuming, the kids. Or Buck, but unfortunately, like, what the hell, Sims? Like, we had it in Sims 2 and Sims 3. We don't have a swing set. We have stupid monkey bars. Like, really? Okay, how many of you, when you went to the playground as a kid, you chose the freaking monkey bars over the swings? Because I want to know, because you are not human. I'm just kidding, but for real. I mean, hello. There's just so many things that I'm missing, y'all. And I've been having so much fun playing, with my Sims 3 Let's Play and my Sims 2 Let's Play. Oh my gosh, I have Sims 2. Yes. I can't wait to finish up with Pleasant View, which I'm excited about. But oh my god, like, I'm ready to move on to Strange Town as well and Veronaville. I'm just so excited to play with all these freaking characters and families that I love so, so much. They're my OG. But anyways, guys, yeah, this family and this house is available for download on the gallery. I hope you enjoyed this build. I know many of you enjoy this series, and I'm so glad that y'all did, because at first when I started, I was like, eh, nobody's gonna like this. But turns out The Sims 2 is probably 9 times out of 10, or at least some of us older ones, maybe not the younger ones, because maybe they didn't play The Sims being that young. I think a lot of, like, the younger Simmers really like The Sims 3. But, like, us older ones that have been playing The Sims for a lot longer, we love The Sims 2 because it's kind of like our OG. So yeah, y'all have loved this series, and y'all are very excited about my Let's Play. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I will see y'all later.